Hi, welcome to the journey with me, Fauntee. This is another beautiful day, and I have a beautiful guest here who is a producer, an actress, a writer, and one of the top Nollywood UK stars at the moment. Stay with me. Hi, welcome back, and I have with me here Tolu Yesufu, who is a producer, actress, and a writer. Welcome.
Thank you very much for having me today.
So today we're talking about, it's all about the movie industry, Nollywood, you know, Gollywood, Hollywood, producing and all that. And you're one of the people making a mark in the country at the moment, representing Nigeria movie industry.
Yeah.
You know, so let's get some gist from you.
Like I said earlier, thank you for having me today. And you know, it's not been an easy journey into the movie industry, but so far so good, we're getting there. And you know, like you said, I'm a movie producer, writer, and an actress as well. And I started acting in the year 2008.
Okay.
And I actually started with a Yoruba movie,
okay,
called Owoju Egun,
okay,
you know, Hard Hand Warning, produced by Ellen Osapute.
Mm-hmm.
And initially, I never even thought I would, you know, be on the screen acting. I have done a bit of drama when I was in school, but I preferred writing because I write a lot. Even when I was young, you know, when we're at home and it's time to have lunch or dinner, my dad would be like, where's Tolu, where's Tolu, where's Tolu? They'll be looking for me. And then they will end up finding me in a corner in my room or in the toilet, locked in the toilet, writing and reading. You know, so I always thought that I would be a writer, write books, novels, and things like that. But the moment I got on set of Owoju Egun in 2008, I realized I had, you know, I loved it, I enjoyed it, and I had a passion for it from then. And that was how I became an actress, you know, alongside being a writer.
Talking about producing, you know, and getting where you are now, your last movie, Murderer in Law, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's making waves. Yeah. I actually watched it. I came for the premiere.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, it was really intense.
Yeah.
How, tell me about it. How the process, producing, you know, let's talk about producing that movie.
Let me start by, when I started writing Murderer in Law, you know, it was like a combination of some real life stories,
okay,
as well as, you know, me having my own thing, my own stuff to it.
Yeah.
You know, like, you know, in real life, I had a friend of mine, like an elder sister, but we're not related, but I call her auntie. You know, she went through something similar. And I thought to myself, because Nollywood, what makes us unique, mm-hmm, is we're not all about fiction, mm-hmm, we're about reality. We tell real stories,
mm-hmm,
stories that people can learn from,
mm-hmm,
you know. And I thought to myself, you know, she might not be the only person that I've been through this.
Yeah.
There might be other people out there that have been through it.
Mm-hmm.
And the way that she dealt with it, it actually yielded a positive outcome for her,
okay,
but it might not yield positive outcome for other people.
Yeah.
You understand? Mm-hmm. So I thought to myself, okay, let me write a story around this,
okay,
add my own bits, you know, and pieces to it, and you know, make it a story, make it nice and interesting, and let people learn from it.
Okay.
And you know, I started thinking about, okay, what title should I call it? We had a working title, different titles came about. And the most commercial title that I had then was Murderer in Law. So I decided to go along with that. And it wasn't easy, you know, because I had to do casting, I had to get the right cast for the roles. Because that is actually one of the problems that we have with Nollywood.
Mm-hmm.
We miscast,
mm-hmm,
sometimes, and it affects the story,
mm-hmm,
it affects the outcome of the whole movie entirely.
Mm-hmm.
So I had to cast and recast till I got the perfect cast, like I would call them, because everybody actually, all my cast, they delivered,
yeah,
you know. And it was an amazing journey. We had fun on set, we had to travel to Maidstone to shoot, and it was fun, and I'm actually happy with the results that we had, you know. But you know, with everything, there's always room for improvement, you know. So no matter how perfect it is, or how perfect I think it, or anybody think it is, I still feel like, you know, there's always room for improvement. But then I'm still happy with what we had.
So is that your first time? Is that the only one you produced yourself?
No. In 2012, I wrote and I produced Shattered Arts.
Oh, did you?
Yeah.
I didn't know.
I did. I wrote and produced it in 2012, and it premiered at the Odeon Cinema as well.
Okay.
And it was a huge success, you know. It was a massive turnout as well.
Okay.
And I had an amazing cast. I had to fly in. It was my first production, so I wanted everything to be perfect. Pictures, sound, and everything. So I flew in Jonathan Benuto.
Mm-hmm.
He does tagging, does work for him.
Okay.
I flew in him. I flew in an Okechukwu editor from Nigeria, flew in Tony Monjaro. We had Peter Edochi on set.
Mm-hmm.
I just wanted it to be perfect, really good as my first production. And it wasn't bad. It wasn't bad, you know. So that was my first production in 2012 as a producer. Shattered Arts.
So how's the journey been? Like, yes, in every story that, you know, when people see it, it's glossy, it's beautiful. Like, there must be something happening behind the scene that nobody... What are the challenges that you face?
Challenges, first of all, I would say would be finance.
Okay.
Sponsorship, because that is one thing, that is one problem that we're facing right now, and we're still struggling with it. But that's why I'm an independent producer.
Okay.
I finance and produce all my movies.
Okay.
With Shattered Arts, I financed it alongside a gentleman called Prince... what's his name now? Prince Bolawo Oluwa.
Okay.
We produced it together. We came together to produce that movie. And with finance then, it wasn't much of a struggle.
Okay.
Because then I had some money with me, and I thought, okay, yes, okay, let's do it, let's do everything. Okay, fly this in one in, fly that one in, bring this in, hotel and all that. It wasn't. But then I realized that budgeting is a big part of production. You need to be careful, even if you have so much money, you need to be careful, because if you don't get your distribution network right, it will be like a waste.
Because
for you to recover,
I was coming to distribution with Nollywood, and I know that people are into Nollywood movies. Are people really paying for it?
Paying for it, you mean
for the movies? Are people really
in the movies?
Yes. Is it really commercial? Is it making money for the producers, or people are just taking advantage of it?
At the moment, I would say with the UK scene, we're getting there. We're not there yet.
I know.
And it's a massive problem we're having. As apart from sponsorship, because you asked me about challenges, apart from sponsorship, distribution network is a massive challenge that we're having right now.
Okay.
And we're still trying to break it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because sometimes I think, like I was saying to a friend and colleague of mine, before we produce these movies, I think we need to get our distribution channels in place.
Mm-hmm.
So by the time these movies are produced, then we'll have a channel to get it out there and make our money from it.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, after producing these films, then we'll not start searching for people to buy it, where to sell it to, and all that. And DVD is not usually the best option to go for first.
Mm-hmm.
And we don't have that much distributors from Nigeria who wants, you know. It's a big challenge. It's a big challenge, distribution.
But personally, how have you coped with, you know, financing this? How has, you know, when you use your own money to do these things, it must affect your pocket and your daily life. So what is the worst,
you know,
you can say you've been through with it?
Some people look at me and, you know, when I say I want to produce a film, they look at me and say, those who know me very well, they look at me and say, are you crazy? Where are you getting the money from? You know, because I have a daily job. I work as a mental health support worker in a mental health project. That's my daily job, you know, apart from by the side, I do the movie things on the side. And I actually do finance my movies from my daily job.
I know, from your pocket. Yeah.
From my pocket, I finance it. I have bills to pay. I have a little girl to take care of. I have rent to pay and all that. But the thing that helps me through it is I don't just, you know, jump into the deep end of the water. Mm-hmm. I plan. Mm-hmm. I plan ahead.
Mm-hmm.
You know. So if I earn, if I'm earning like 2-5 in a month, in that month I'm saying to myself, okay, I'm keeping like 700 apart because I'm looking towards producing a film.
Mm-hmm.
So that 700, I know I'm paying at least one or two casts from it.
Mm-hmm.
So by the time I keep saving that way, and I don't wait till production date to pay my cast.
Mm-hmm.
The moment I know my cast, I pay them half up front.
Mm-hmm.
So when it's time to start producing this film or going on set, it's mm-hmm. easier, with the burden is easier because I've paid upfront, you know, so it's much more easier for me to take care of other bills.
Mm-hmm.
So back to your question, it's not easy financially, but the most important thing that will help you through is planning and actually having a passion for it. If you don't have a passion for it,
forget about it.
It's very stressful. You would just do it halfway and you would stop
and
give up, and it will be like a waste of money and everything. If you don't have a passion for it, you can. Especially in the UK, because the challenges is so much. Yeah. Honestly, I tell you, challenges is so much.
Yeah.
And a lot of people still don't believe in us. And sometimes you wouldn't blame them, let's be honest here.
Mm-hmm.
Because you look at the quality of some films that have been produced in the UK, and you're thinking to yourself, for God's sake.
Okay, you know? Now, talking about people believing in the Nollywood UK and the, you know, production and things like that, how do you people coordinate your PR? Is there, I noticed, you know, being in the media part, I found that communication, the Nollywood industry, their communication with the media, you know, is, they take it more like personal, they don't do professionally.
Mm-hmm.
For example, there was a lady that produced, one of the producers that produced a series or something. And I went out of my way because I found out that movie was, you know, what she was producing was nice. So I went out of my way to ask for their, you know, press kit and things like that. And I didn't know what press kit was. So how do you get on things like that, like PR, sorting it out and making sure that the message is your branding, your movies and brand as well properly?
I think that's one of the things that producers need to sit down and actually look at. You can't say because you're a producer and you've got a good product, you can market it or put it out there yourself. You know, publicity is a huge part of what we do.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and it's a learning process. We learn every day.
Mm-hmm.
Things like what you just spoke about now, there are things that you have to go out of your way as a producer to learn, to educate yourself about. There's nothing like being ignorant in the business. If it's what you really want to do, you have to learn about these things.
Mm-hmm.
You have to, you know, speak to media personalities, get used to them, get used to their terms, like what you just said now, everything. And, you know, you need the media, actually.
Okay.
Because publicity is actually very, very important.
It's one of the first things. You know?
It is.
Because, as a producer, in fact, you shouldn't be the one, you shouldn't be the spokesperson as well.
Exactly.
Because sometimes when the media want to talk to somebody,
mm-hmm.
you know, you might be busy producing your movie, so there has to be someone there speaking for you.
Exactly.
Now, we, you know, all the process of it, as usual, on my show, I try to get the story, but the bad, the ugly, the negative, because you can't see the shining ball without, you know, knowing that a hand was, you know, got dirty cleaning it. So now we've talked about all the debts and things. Now let's focus. I want to focus now. How many awards have you won? How many awards? Because everything is like, you won BAFTA, you won CA awards. It's just like, it's only you now.
So, oh God, we thank God. You know, it's not all about winning. It's, you know, getting nominated for these awards alone. It uplifts your spirit. You know, it makes you realize that I'm doing something that people are actually noticing. You know, they notice I'm doing this.
That's one thing people don't understand. Awards, you know, is a form of congratulating somebody for what they do.
Yeah.
So sometimes people think it's a child's play, it's not.
They don't take it serious.
Yeah.
And the thing is, if you are a producer, if you're an actress, a director, whatever you do in front or behind the scene. Mm-hmm. If you get if you actually have passion mm-hmm. for what you do, mm-hmm. if you get a nomination, mm-hmm. it will mean a lot to you.
Exactly.
Because you're passionate about what you're doing. If you're an actress because you want to be famous, because you want people to see you on screen, the moment you don't get nominated, or even if you get nominated, you won't appreciate it. You won't appreciate it. But somebody who has gone, you know, in their room to write a story, to produce it, or a director behind the scene who has gone through the stress of actually directing a movie that they have a passion for, it's something they have a passion for. Yeah. If they get a nomination alone, even if they don't win the award, it means a lot to them. You know, that's why you see in Hollywood, being nominated alone is a big deal to them. Even if they don't win the award, being nominated, when they're interviewing them, you will think they are the one that have actually received the award. You know, it's a big deal to them.
Yeah.
But, you know, and but some people feel like, oh God, I've been nominated. Anyway, I know I'm not going to win the award or whatever, but it doesn't matter. You're being nominated is an, you know, you've been appreciated in one way or the other.
That means somebody actually sees that.
Yeah, exactly.
So what's your, in general now, first of all, what do you think has really, you know, given you the successes that you've achieved at, you know, at the moment? Now, at least when people are ranking in the Nollywood UK, you are one of the first people that will be called, you know, for me, you've been the one of the, you know, first 10 female actresses and producers, you know, of Nollywood here. Yeah. So what is your secret? How have you been, you know, going on to the level you are now?
I'll be honest with you, my secret, I would say, is just God.
Okay.
That is my secret. And I try not to let fear be an obstacle to me.
Okay.
Even if I feel like I've done something and it hasn't worked the way I want it to work,
okay,
I don't go into my self-pity corner and start, you know, I don't wallow in self-pity. Mm-hmm. To me, I always think, next step.
What's the next step?
What can I do next? What should I do next? You know, like I'm planning to do a TV series now. And the moment it went on Facebook that I was doing a TV series, a friend of mine called me and said, Tolu, are you serious? It costs a lot of money. It takes so much time. And all that. Aren't you scared? I said, fear is the last thing that I'm thinking of. Because the moment I start getting scared, that's
the end of that story.
So I would say it's, first of all, God. And then the second thing is, and you know, I don't let fear overwhelm me.
Okay. So how do you handle criticism? When people criticize your work or, you know, point out something, some will be, you know, constructive, some comes in any way, in any form. So how do you cope with those?
I don't let it affect me, you know. I criticize myself a lot,
okay,
and I criticize my work a lot. If you give me a constructive criticism, I appreciate it. I go back to the drawing board and I try to work to improve on the criticism.
Yeah.
If you're giving me a bad criticism, to me, I look at it and I wait and is it something that will help me in the future? If it is, yes, I see it.
Mm-hmm.
I see what you give me. Okay. You know, I see the ones that doesn't make any sense, and I take the ones that does actually make sense,
mm-hmm.
and then I try to improve on it. I am my own worst critic,
mm-hmm.
you know, so I do appreciate, like my mother-in-law is online now, people mm-hmm. watch it online, and then when I send messages to certain people and they reply and I say, oh, Tolu, I've actually watched it, it's nice, but I send a message back to them and say, what criticism do you have about it? What do you think I could do better with Modra in, you know, in my next movie?
Okay.
And some of them just say, oh, you could do this better, you could do that better. Some of them will say, oh, as far as I'm concerned, it's okay.
Which is fine.
Yeah.
It's their own opinion.
Yeah. If you can't accept criticism,
So what is next for Tolu Yesufu?
Okay, for me, I've got a future film I'm planning to do.
Okay.
It's completely different from Modra in Law.
Are you going to come back to me to tell my audience about it?
I will definitely. Okay. And I've got a TV series I'm planning to shoot as well.
Okay.
It's, you know, it's an amazing story. And the future story as well is different from Modra in Law, like I said. It's not a drama comedy.
Okay.
I've got two beautiful productions that I'm planning to do now.
Now you've seen, you've had all the story behind the scene always my in the journey, I try to bring out those stories you're not seeing. Again, when you see the shining light, someone is cleaning it. And when you see, hear or see that the other side of the sea or whatever is greener, somebody's watering it. So those are the stories we want to find out. And with Tolu Yesufu today, the producer of Mother-in-Law and many other movies, Nollywood industry, UK, keeps climbing. And these are the stories we are bringing to you on the journey. Let me know your thoughts on this show today. Just and make sure you subscribe as well. There are lots and lots of stories coming your way from all over the world. Keep watching. Thank you.